There is a being so incensed by man's happiness that he has made it his life's work to ensure that man does not enjoy the happiness of his father, God. This is the story of a fallen angel, the fallen angel, Satan, who after losing his chance at eternal happiness, now spends his days doing whatever he can to ensure that man too loses the peace, the love, the true happiness that only Christ can provide his children.
Look, I'm so upset. You guys are letting these people get closer and closer to God during quarantine. What is your job here? Isn't it to tempt people? They're reading the Igbea, they're going to liturgies, they're even reading the Bible! I need you to give me an idea, I need you to give me an idea, and I need you to give me an idea. Go!
We can
tempt
them during liturgy.
Are you stupid? Tempt them during liturgy? That is so dumb!
We can make them cheat on their tests in school.
Yeah, you have the biggest eyebrows, but not the biggest brain in school, I can tell. Yo, give me an idea now!
We could break their fast.
I can help her.
I'll break both of you if you guys say another stupid idea like that.
I made them go to parties and stuff.
Enough with the stupidity. I don't want to hear it anymore. I need good ideas! Do you know what a good idea is? By the end of these 24 hours, if you guys don't give me good ideas, you will be dead. Go!
The saints were happiest when they were in deep prayer. Spiritual ecstasy is what they called the state where you would be so deep in communication with God that many would actually start to levitate or see heavenly visions right in the middle of prayer. Why then is it so hard to enjoy the liturgy?
Oh my God.
Marcy, get off your phone.
Okay.
Like now. Get off your phone
what?
Now.
I'm snapping, George. Do you want to say hi?
No, I don't. We're in the middle of liturgy. Just get up.
Stop grabbing
How
me, first of all.
Just get up. Bissu Sabib.
Shh. You're not my mom.
Oh, you're acting like a baby. Just get up.
Fine.
Oh, wow.
Oh my God. I like literally can't believe you. I don't want to put my phone away.
Well, we're in the middle of liturgy.
Give
you should have some respect.
See,
people are looking at us now. Just put your phone away and act responsible.
It's your fault, but fine.
Marcy! Your best friends have Snapchatted you maybe like 5 times. Wouldn't you want to go see? Or else they'll get mad at you.
I'm going to the bathroom, Mom.
Saint Anthony the Great would often warn his spiritual children that laziness, anxiety, and fear are tools the demons use to sow insecurity, unhappiness, and sin into our hearts.
All right, class, today's your final exam. It's 30% of your grade, so pay attention. You have 1 hour and keep your eye on your own test. Good luck.
So it looks like you forgot to study. Well, guess what? That means you're gonna fail this final exam.
Just cheat, guys. Everyone does it.
Yo, Miriam, I don't know anything on this exam. Let's just cheat.
Are you crazy? The teacher's right there.
Okay, would you rather fail? Just cheat off Christine over there. Let's go.
Okay, it's you.
Saint John Chrysostom once gave a homily on how fasting is the greatest shield against Satan. Though we give up so much food when we restrict the body from indulging, we end up feeding our souls, spiritual nourishment that leaves us so full and so happy in the way food could never accomplish for us.
Oh my goodness, that liturgy was so long.
And we're fasting.
I know, the whole time all I'm thinking about pizza, cheeseburgers,
chocolate.
Oh my God, I miss chocolate.
Yeah, I miss everything.
Yeah.
Hey Miriam, don't you want to go try those chocolates? I just heard you complaining about how hungry you were. Come on, go take a try at them.
Hey Marcy, speaking of chocolate, do you want one?
Oh my God, I wish, but I mean, we're fasting.
Oh no, I know. Just one though.
We're fasting. We can't break the fast. We can't.
Hey, Marcy, come on, you know how good those chocolates taste like. You should go try them. It won't hurt anyone.
Here, just have one. I promise. Just one and that's it. We could go back to fasting tomorrow.
Just one?
Just one.
All right. Oh my goodness. I miss this.
I miss this too. Mm.
Oh my goodness.
I told you.
I feel like we're doing something wrong.
No one's around. It's okay. I won't say anything.
Okay.
Okay.
Our Father, Clement of Alexandria, warned the youth of his time to abstain from partying and wine, as these inflamed the wild impulses of sin.
Oh, that was really good.
You didn't even get one ball in.
Let's see how you do.
Okay.
You're so horrible at it, oh my god.
Your turn.
My turn.
Wait, hold on. Did you get a message from Alexa?
Yeah.
She said there's a party at her house tonight.
No way! Let's go!
I don't think I want to go.
What do you mean you don't want to go?
Isn't it Sunday school at 7:30 anyway?
Oh, what are we gonna do?
You got church every weekend. The party only comes once a year. You have to go.
But I'm gonna feel guilty the whole time. Plus, everyone there is so boring. I'm not gonna have any fun.
Yeah, you're right. I would feel too bad if we skipped church.
You're going to liturgy tomorrow anyways. Why would you need to go today too?
You're right. I need to stop stressing myself out so much. You wanna go to the party?
Yes, let's go party!
Let's go.
Alright, my little devils. What did you do while I was gone?
Okay, listen. Hear me out. I went to Abuna in liturgy and everybody was standing there. And I went and I got this girl to go on her phone. And then everyone started going crazy. And I got Abuna to stop liturgy.
Stop the liturgy?
Yeah.
And everyone went crazy. Mm-hmm. I like that. Keep that up.
Come on, that's a snooze fest. Mine was so much better. Guess what? I made them cheat on their final exam.
On the final, eyebrows.
Yup.
They failed too.
Yeah, they got 6%.
I like it, eyebrows. Keep up the good work.
Well, I made them break their fast.
No, I didn't.
I don't care who did it, but good job to both of you. I don't care.
No. Mine was better than all of yours. You know what I did?
What? What'd you do?
I made them go to a party instead of go to Sunday school for 2 weeks in a row.
2 weeks in a row, a party.
Yeah.
You partied with them?
Yeah, party was lit.
Alright, good. That's how demons roll around here. Good job, my demons. I am very pleasant with what you guys have done. You guys have relaxed me. Keep these people in temptation constantly. And do not let them realize God's happiness in them. Keep it far away from them.
The Lord saw that his children were leaning away from him. So he sent one of his angels to show them the way back.
So, where do you guys want to get pizza today?
I think something opened down the street, right, Mary?
Yeah, it's like 5 minutes away from here.
Let's go there. That should be good.
Okay.
Oh my goodness.
Hello, beloved children of God. How are you feeling today? I think you guys have been straying away from God. What's going on?
I've just been like sinning a lot lately and been tempted to do a lot of things.
I agree. Me too.
Yeah, me too.
I think I know the problem.
What is it?
You see, I think this is the work of the devil. You guys have to start getting close to God again.
How do we do that?
So simple. You guys need to get a Father of Confession and start confessing. And the Bible is a very good resource for you and it will help you through a lot of things. You can learn a lot of stuff from the Bible. And praying is very, very important too. Just treat God as your friend. It's very simple.
You're right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Where'd she go?
Oh my God. God bless us today. Thank you, Abuna. I'll talk to you later. Guys, I love confession with Abuna. It makes me feel so good.
Yeah, me too. I feel so relieved now.
We need to do this a lot more often.
Yes, we do. We all need to get really close to God.
Honestly, I agree.
Yeah, me too.
Here's a secret Satan does not want you to know. You see, the mechanism by which he separates you from the only source of authentic happiness in your life is by attacking your purity. The more sins you commit to your soul, the farther you are from God, the less happy you are. Though in words, this cause and effect is very clear. In practice, it's a lot more cloudy. As the demons incites us to commit sin more and more, and the distance between God and us grow and grow, an emptiness begins to form inside us. An emptiness that will be filled with the wrong things. Drugs, relationship, money, status, fame, and power. Whatever it is, we'll try to throw it into a bottomless pit that forms within our hearts. It will never be enough. Maybe you get a few minutes of pleasure out of it, but it's long before you're right back to that deceptive pit that you allow to exist in your life. What is the only thing that can fill a pit with no bottom? The pit of despair where you spend your whole life in freefall, wishing for the end to the pain, end that never comes. Simply put, God. God is the only force in the world that is truly infinite, is the only being that can fill a void that has no end. The Holy Spirit is the only power able to bring us out of that freefall that we're trapped in, and bring us back to the only path, back to the authentic happiness and joy. Jesus Christ and his limitless love for us is the only person that can cleanse our hearts and souls, remove all the sadness, depression, and despair that the enemy sows within us, and then pulls us into a sweet, fatherly embrace that there is no pain. There is no fear, there's no anxiety, just an abundance of happiness. Just endless joy, eternal love. If there is any sadness, it is this, that many of our brothers and sisters will never know this happiness, this joy, this love, and is only because they're so trapped within themselves, in selfishness, in this lost world, they will never wake up from slumber, which the enemy has put them in. For as long as we struggle to find our way back to God, the demons struggle harder. It is only by casting our eyes upon the cross and calling for our one and only Savior to help do we even have a chance. Until then, as the prophet Isaiah warned, there is no rest for the wicked.